We are covered in microbes, which are bacteria and fungi, right now, inside and out, whether we like it or not. We should celebrate them. These microbes are generally considered good. They help our immune system develop, and they help kill the bad microbes that make us sick. Sometimes we even take good microbes, called probiotics, to keep us healthy. And other times we take antibiotics. But what if you were dying of a deadly disease and you couldn't take an antibiotic? You're a bat, a bird, a frog, a salamander, and a bad microbe has invaded your habitat, and it's killing you and your relatives by the millions. This is happening right now across the globe. It is causing large losses to global biodiversity and unknown damage to ecosystems and forest stability. In some instances, humans are accidentally introducing these bad microbes into new habitats. For my dissertation, I am studying how good microbes may protect amphibians, which are frogs and salamanders, from a bad microbe. The bad microbe, called Batrachochytrium dendrobatidis, which I will just call BD, is a fungal pathogen that infects the skin of amphibians. This is particularly deadly for amphibians because they breathe across their skin. BD has been implicated in the die-offs of more than 100 species of amphibians worldwide. But in my research, I discovered that woodland salamanders are rarely infected with BD, even though it often occurs in the habitat in which they live. My hypothesis is the good microbes on these salamanders are protecting them from the bad microbe BD. To test this, I cultured bacteria from the skin of 3 species of woodland salamanders in the eastern United States. Then I determined which of these bacteria could kill BD in culture. Then I used new DNA sequencing technology to determine how abundant the good microbes were. I found 73 unique bacteria that could kill the bad microbe, BD. I found those bacteria make up more than 40% of the bacteria living on the salamander skin. So 40% of the bacteria can kill the bad microbe, BD. This suggests woodland salamanders are protected from BD due to their good microbes. But why care about woodland salamanders and their microbes? Because what we learn from woodland salamanders aids in developing conservation strategies for amphibians dying from BD. Further, the methods we develop, the insight we gain, applies to all organisms that get infected by bad microbes. Using good microbes to prevent disease, often called probiotic therapy, is an active line of research in chestnut tree, coral, and bat conservation, in aquaculture, in agriculture, and also in human medicine. Let's celebrate these protective good microbes.